Hello everyone, how are you doing today? Seike Igbiriki, Nigeria's number one Realtor. Today I'll be talking about a very, very interesting topic. A topic where I've gotten a lot of clients, you know, discussing, you know, about this topic, and I think I should, do this so people can learn from it. And what is it? We're talking about cheap properties. What you need to know before you invest in cheap properties. Yes, the pointers you need to watch out for. If you're investing in cheap properties, watch this video till the end before so your fingers don't get burnt at the end of the transaction. So first of all, what's cheap? It's not bad if something is cheap. Cheap, basically, we know the normal definition, things that are of lower, that are of low price, you know, low prices, things that have low prices, those are cheap things, right? And they are in real estate and everywhere, you know, we have low price stuffs in real estate, so you have cheap lands, cheap houses, you know. So, but like I said, it's not bad if an investment is cheap, but it shouldn't be your number one reason. It shouldn't be your main motive for going into a real estate transaction, because your fingers might get burnt at the end of the day if that's your primary reason and you're blinded by the fact that a property is cheap. A property is cheap. So if you're going for cheap properties, you need to watch out for these. Number one, a cheap property might have, in fact, in many cases, return on investment is very, very low. It's not encouraging, very, very poor. So, and me personally, if I'm going to invest, I watch out for return on investment. These are things that excite me. I buy so amount, and before you know what happens, the price goes up, you know, or I buy so amount, and then from time to time, I'm able to get a particular amount per annum or monthly, or, you know, from time to time, you know, get cash flow. You know, but cheap properties, in many cases, if you are going for cheap properties, it's quite that the rate of return on investment is very low. Cash flow, very, very poor. Rate of capital appreciation, next is at almost zero. You know, you buy a property, maybe a land for maybe 200,000, and then in 2-3 years time, it's quite that the property has not really appreciated, you know. But if you check out that same property that was bought, maybe bought the same time with another property, maybe of 10 million naira or 15 million naira in a better location, far better location, you discover that that property would have appreciated, while the one that you bought cheap, you know, with all joy and happiness and thinking you made a smart move, you know, the rate of the return on investment on such properties in many cases is very, very low. So the return on investment in most cases for cheap properties are very, very low. That's number one. Then number two, mostly cheap properties have no title. They have no title, most of them. They have maybe just payment receipts, or they have payment receipt that anybody can just do. You can go to business center, you know, you can do a payment receipt, you know. So cheap properties, in many cases, they have just payment receipts. And even if they have something else, maybe they have deed of assignment that is not registered, you know, in the court, or maybe a survey that is still not registered. You know, all those kind of properties, you know, they might have some issues. At the end of the day, yes, they'll sell it cheap for you, but you might encounter a lot of problems, you know. And if you have no title, if your property has no title, that means you have no right to, you have no right to own the property. You have no interest. Your interest is not protected. The title helps you protect your interest and shows you your right. So if you are investing in the property and there's no title, come on. You think it's cheap, come on, you've made a very, very costly mistake, and you'll be selling yourself cheap. In fact, you've sold yourself cheap. So that's number two, mostly no title. Then number three, it could be a wrong investment. What do I mean, wrong investment? Maybe a property is supposed to be for agricultural purpose, you know, like maybe the government has zoned a particular area, you know, as an agricultural zone, meaning if you buy properties there, whatever it is that you do, you must make sure it is agriculturally related, or it's agriculture, you know. But if you go ahead and say, hey, I want to, because those kind of properties, those agricultural properties, generally sell, they're even cheap, and they buy them, they sell them in acres, you know, in many cases, you know, sell them in acres, and yet they are very cheap. So if you don't know, you don't do your due diligence, you just go ahead and then you get such properties, and maybe you want to use it for maybe a school, you want to build a factory, you want to maybe build a residential apartment, a building or something that you want to stay, or something different from agriculture that you never knew that it was the purpose. You go ahead, you buy such properties. Yes, it's cheap, but come on, you've made a wrong investment and you can't use it for that purpose. That's number three. I'll be sharing four other pointers, you know, but that will be in my next video. So we'll be doing a part two of that this video. So this part one, I hope you learned something new. You might just want to ask me one or two questions, or just drop a comment and I'll be glad to reply. Thank you very much and have a great day. Boom.